I just want to show you the best approach when it comes to writing your API endpoints. So what you should do first is focus on business entities. And these entities are often grouped into collections. So maybe orders, transactions, payments, so on and so forth. And be aware that these entities, I'm not saying customer, I'm saying customers. And then I'll show you how you can basically get one customer off the path. So if you're new to the channel, literally just take 1 second, subscribe. Also smash that like button, literally smash that like button so I can keep on recording these videos for you guys. So a bunch of you guys have requested more code reveals. So here we go. But have a look. So here, request mapping, and then here, unsecured. Now this is literally, do not do this, right? Because here you're just asking for trouble. Literally, that's everything you're doing, right? So if you want to leave an API endpoint which doesn't have any security whatsoever, then you can use like ant matchers, and you can say, look, anything that falls under this API endpoint or under this path shouldn't have any security, right? Otherwise, apply some sort of security, whether it's basic authentication, form-based, API key, or auth, whatever, right? So this actually should go. So let's just remove this from here. And have a look. So you've got API, V1, and then products. So this is actually quite good. But what we could do is we could take this from here, so products, and basically delete the whole thing, actually, and put it right here, right? So API V1 and then products. And anytime that there's a get mapping onto this path, this is the method that will be invoked, right? And also unsecured controller. So this is, you need to have a better name, right? So this should be the products, the product controller, right? So it deals with products. So you can rename that as well. So this is bad naming. And right here, so have a look, we've got get and then forward slash and then image. Now in here, so check this out. So forward slash get forward slash image and then ID. Now which ID is this? So to me it looks like that this is the ID for the product. So a product has an image. So product service get image by, or get image by based on ID. So I think what you want in here is the following. So you want to replace that. So if I just duplicate this and just leave a comment here, so you see. So you want to say that in here. So this will be the product ID. So product ID and then forward slash and then image. So you can see how simple this is, right? So instead of you saying get and then image, like you don't need to say get because this is a get mapping. So this method will handle get HTTP requests. So you can remove the get from the path. And then the image is based off a product. So products. So here. So API V1 products. And then the product ID. So product maybe one. And then the actual image. So this is a much better design. Now, the second one, so the second controller you have in here is secured. Like, so you have insecure, and then you've got secured. Like, literally, don't do this, right? So you see that basically all of these, they should be under the same controller. And I'm not sure why this is secured and then the other one is not secured. So, but let me just basically focus on the actual API endpoints. So here. Again, we can remove that from there. Oh, okay. So this one is V2 and this is V1. Right. Okay. Yeah. So there's no need for you to say secure or insecure because you could just say anything that is API V1 and then products has no security. The version 2 now has security, right? So here, let's just say API V2 and then products. And what we're going to do is the following. So here you can remove this product from here and you can say just ID, right? So this will be /, so API v2 products, /, and then the ID, and then you get a product. Now, if you want to add a new product, there's no need for you to say add new, like this is bad. And also the naming convention is wrong, right? So this is mainly for path variables. So this is wrong, or query params, right? So you don't need to say that. Why? Because, so here, just use the REST semantics, right? So post mapping to products, right? And here you are actually passing a new product. So you pass in the product and whatever, and I can see that you have a file in here. So that is sufficient, right? So no need to say add new. So just use post. So post allows you to add a new resource and just use the name, just use REST, right? So let's just have a look. So again here, so post and then mapping edit. So basically you want to edit a product. So here this would be put instead of post. So put, just like that. And you can remove edit. So there's no need for edit there. And this could have the same path as this one. As, where is it? Yeah, so as this one, right? So this one is a get. So given an ID, you get it. And then this one, given the ID, but this will be put. So put updating an existing resource. And this is much better. Then delete. So the same thing with delete. We could just remove the name from here, just like that. And then just use delete mapping in here, which is delete HTTP, right? So deleting an existing resource from your system. So this is much better instead of you doing all of that nonsense. Cool. Let me move on to the next repo. So we've got API v1 and then cars. So I like the versioning that you guys have in here. So that's nice. And then you have user and then user ID. So you want to get all the cars by the user. So we can simplify this like this, like that. And so cars and then /, and we could say users and then passing the user ID. Or so the other way of doing this is, if this was on a separate resource, what you could do is you could say, right, so this would be users and then user ID and then /, and then cars. Yeah, so you can see that how we do it the other way around, right? So from users, we go to ID, we go grab the user, and then we list the cars for that particular user, right? So this wouldn't fall under this path right here. So this would be API. So basically API v1 or v2 users on in here, basically, right? So I'm just showing you two ways of doing it. So let me just put that back. So then here you have get mapping. So get car by ID. I don't think you need all of this, just like that. So car ID. And here then correctly. So update the car. You pass the car ID. And then I think this should be car update request, right? Because you might want to limit the fields that the client sends to your server, and maybe just want to allow them to update the price, for example, or the mileage, for example, right? So not the ID and the brand, for example. So those are things that you don't update on a car. So I think, so for this, I think, yeah, we've got more controllers, but here, car part controller. So I think, yeah, so working on better names here. So you've got get mapping. I'm not sure why this is question mark, and then post. So here you've done the right thing, right? So add new car part. So repair, API v1, and then repairs. So let's use plural here. Then basically you've got like something weird going on here. So you've combined like, you know, multiple services within your controller, which you shouldn't do this, right? So you should have everything layered. So using the N-tier architecture or any other pattern that you or your team follow, right? So this is wrong. Let me just move on to the next repo, so this video doesn't get too long. This one here, it's a Kotlin project. So again here, so we could say accounts, so API v1 accounts, and no need to say create because the post mapping will take care of that, right? So we can get rid of that. And we have verify, so accounts, and then we verify, so that's fine. And then let's look into calendar. So iCal, so here, this, okay, so if you don't use versioning, that's fine, which I think you should, but export and then title, start date. Now, these right here, they should be query params. They should be query params, okay? So it's a path variable, which is incorrect because you could export and then you could just say like, look, I want the title to be mandatory and export, which is a calendar. I think it's a calendar that you do that you're working with, right? So maybe you do something like this. So export iCal title. So this would be part of the path or maybe the ID of the calendar, and then /export. And then these right here, they would be the query params. So not even here, but you would have them here somehow as query params. And then this allows you to do this, right? So if I put comment here, so you could say iCal / and then foo, let's say that's the title, export, and then ?, and then the start date equals to some date, and end date equals to some date. Yeah. And these could be optional. So if they're optional, then you can say, look, I'll give you the last month, for example. Yeah. So this is much better. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Now let's look into the last one. So the last one is from, so open recent projects. I think it's car rental agency. So again, API v1 car, and then save. Don't do this. So here, let's just say cars, and then post into cars, and that's it. All right, so this is much simpler. And then list ID, and then passing the ID. This is wrong. So you should say cars, so fetch car by ID. You could just pass the ID just like that. Yeah, because this is under API v1 cars, and then the ID is a path variable. Then here, list registration number, and this would be maybe like that. So that's better naming there, but right, and then you've got list, and then basically you're gonna fetch the car by name, right? And then by kilometer and whatnot. So you could actually simplify some of this with query params, and then you could basically reduce the number of endpoints that you have in here. Let's look into customer controller. So here, customers, don't do list, and you can get rid of that. So this also goes, and fetch customer by email. So you could remove that, and then email, right? And post mapping, save a customer. So you see where I'm going with this, right? So here, even you don't need deleting here because we just use the delete method from HTTP. And the same with update. So update, it's put, well done. And this is it. So I think that there's a bunch of improvements, but hopefully this makes sense. So yeah, so again, so a bunch of these things here that you should change. Transaction controller, so transactions and whatnot. Awesome, so this is pretty much what I wanted to cover in this video. Literally, just let me know what you thought about this video. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to record a video on API design best practices, where I'll basically tell you everything that you need to know in order to build APIs that will not suffer from these anomalies, right? And the key is, if you deploy this stuff to production, then you are in big, big trouble, right? So when it comes to, update these endpoints, let's say that you have thousands and thousands of clients, then it's not an easy job. Trust me, it's not an easy job. So learn how to properly design your APIs, and I'll get a video for it next week, probably, or this week. I'll see how it goes. Comment down below, smash the like button, and I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.